welcome everybody to the 16th episode of Dollar Ben of Doom. Aaron is joining us again.
Yeah.
Return guest.
Our first repeat return guest.
Yes.
I fucking hate you.
You picked it! Fuck you!
Still fucking hate you. I'm on an empty stomach. I had a gin and tonic, and I'm feeling like I want to kill myself.
A little sad.
A little sad.
When someone asks, like, hey, what'd you do on Wednesday? You're going to have that, like, dog staring at the cupcakes that he can't eat.
Yeah, just the flashbacks.
Yeah.
Just like, Aaron, you're peeing. Stop. Quit it.
Stop. Seen any good movies lately? Why are you sweating so much?
So anyway, we watched, what the fuck is this piece of shit called?
Fartbox 1.0.
Gamebox 1.0.
All right, so Charlie Nash is an expert video game tester whose life has become
faster.
Unbearable. No, you read it. We watched this fucking stupid movie that I thought was going to be cool.
Yeah, we did.
Okay, like, jokes aside, how did everyone feel about this movie?
I fucking hated it.
Okay.
Like, not even in, like, a fun, ha ha ha, this, like, funny, bad, like, every other thing you guys have done. This is just, like, a big disappointing nothing burger of garbage and like this is like a sandwich where the middle filling is just more fucking bread. That's what this was. Just like
or just like mayonnaise.
Not even mayonnaise. That's too fucking spicy. It's literally just another
Okay, well that's your opinion. Kevin?
Do you want my opinion?
I do.
Out of arm's length for me? Because you're about to get fucking strangled.
So this one makes me sad that we always record these seconds after finishing the movie. Immediately after finishing it, we're just like, oh, fuck this movie. But in hindsight, I think there's a lot of goofy bullshit and it's more enjoyable.
I'm inclined to believe you.
Was he watching the same movie I
know, I'm inclined to believe him just because a movie like this is exhausting.
I'm
so fucking tired.
Kevin enjoyed it, I could tell, but he was also tired by the end because this movie holds you, you know, like a good horror film holds you in suspense the whole ride, and at the end it lets you down.
All right.
This is like a good horror film, but absolutely not intentional because you're held at this level of baffled for an extended period of time, and it uses a lot of energy. There's a lot of energy required to keep you at that level of, what the fuck is going on?
Should we get into the story? We're 20 minutes into this discussion.
Was there a story? Like, I genuinely had a hard time.
I don't think the story is complicated.
No.
Basically, the guy...
Chris.
Charlie. His name is Charlie.
He works as a beta tester for games.
Yeah, and he is a beta, for sure.
Beta cuck, for sure.
He gets delivered a video game and is put under the impression that it's for him to test. And the game makes him, like, scan his life, basically.
Yeah, he gets his vape, and they're like, hey, shitbag, scan some people that you are
dumb
in contact
cunt.
With. Yeah. And then he just goes around and vapes near people and just, like, yeet, yeet. And then he just takes a bunch of pictures.
And he steals their souls.
Yeah, his friends that are trying to be nice, and they're like, because he's still mourning the loss of his girlfriend who got shot by a cop, even though she's not black.
They never say how long she's been dead. They're just like, oh, she died. I mean, in my head, she's been dead for like 3 years.
I was going to say 3 years is good because like it makes him look more pathetic. And his friends are like, come on, you really got to move on.
Like,
we're having a barbecue. Like,
come have some fucking hot dogs. Like, yeah. So Charlie is a sad boy because.
Is there a movie about an evil vape? It's 2019. There has to be a movie about an evil vape.
Those are just called Subaru commercials.
So back to my point, this is when the movie peaks, when he puts on the thing and he goes into the video game world.
This is 15 minutes into the movie.
Yeah, because that first hit is just
sensory overload with how insane everything is.
Well, because
it's just stock 3D assets that aren't sized properly and
they don't move right.
Bad texturing.
Bad lighting.
Bad, terrible lighting.
This is where my
prowess
falls.
And then just an obvious person transposed on a bad 3D background. And this was the movie. We were like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
And it was so crazy right out the gate that we were hooked. And then it never really stopped doing that.
Which I think is why I wanted to start killing myself. Is because I was like...
It gets tiring really quick.
It does. Because it stopped being like, this is so ridiculous. Oh, look, her nose is disappearing because of the goddamn green screen. And look, part of the room is showing through the fucking motorcycle.
Yeah.
When he was climbing up the wall rock, horrible, like, interacting with
when he'd take a corner on the street while driving the motorcycle, he wouldn't change speed. He would just whip
Which
into
is like
the...
very, very Tron-like.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think that was our biggest issue with it.
But it was bananas. It was outrageous.
Loved it. I shook your hand at that moment.
That's right.
Thank you for choosing it.
And I at that point, I was having a fun time.
Right. But from that point over, for the next 15 minutes, we were almost silent.
I kept trying to take pictures of Sam with his mouth agape.
Yeah.
He kept getting mad at me.
I was leaning toward the screen with my mouth fucking open like an idiot. Just like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
But you know what? You know what this reminds me of? You remember G4 television?
Yeah.
All the programming that you're like, this is about video games, but it feels like no one here actually plays video games.
Yeah.
This fucking movie. This is like a movie that they would have filmed for that channel. Like, it is the same budget that they would have had.
The first G4 original movie.
Exactly right. And it's the era, too.
Yeah.
It's like right in that era.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Like PS2, original Xbox era.
Okay, so here's my question. We all have veto power when we're watching this movie.
Yeah.
The soul of my soul was screaming, stop watching this. Pick a better one. This is not fun for you at your core. But I didn't.
Should have spoke up, man.
Why didn't you?
That's the question I am posing to all of you.
Ah.
And I was holding out, and I watched this entire white tube sock of a movie because I was hoping the jump the shark moment would happen. Where it just goes out there, you know, where like something weird happens that leaves us all laughing.
I would disagree with you that it never happened. I would say it happened so early in the movie that he jumped the shark and then he never landed. So the whole movie is the whoa, and that's exhausting when you have another 50 minutes of whoa.
Yeah, that's true. What was the moment?
The first time he goes into the video game world.
You know, I think you're right.
But it throws all of that at you at once, and we're laughing and we're having fun, and but it never either steps up to something new that's baffling or does some, like I said, it never goes anywhere. It just kind of, it hits it, and then it just hits
and
it
then
the
whole
movie,
the movie happens inside the video game.
So
okay.
It hits its peak really early, but then it's all peak. But if it's all peak, none of it's peak.
Right.
Yeah, funny.
I'm glad we had gin for this episode.
You guys did have a drink or two.
We did, and it didn't make it any better.
Maybe that's why you're so angry. You're like...
I'm not an angry drunk. I just fight people.
So this is 2003. Clearly, if this had any budget, it was completely like self-funded by someone. And they were using consumer-grade effects equipment, right? So no 3D rendering of the era. It was all stock shit. So of course it was gonna look bad, but the people who made the movie didn't feel that it looked bad enough not to do it.
Yeah, it's a good point.
Which to me, I mean, again, maybe in its time.
Maybe that plays to the endearing factor that kept us glued into it.
Yeah, that was I think that's what locked us in. Past the point of no return. Like, there's a 30-minute mark where you just are like, all right, can we quit this movie? Once you get past that 30-minute mark, it's like, all right, we're in it. Like,
we're doing it.
It's not worth restarting.
And the first 15 minutes, he was just moping around.
Literally, but, like, emotionless. And I was saying that I don't understand. Like, if there was no music, I would have no idea how to feel because he was just stone dead, just not... any sort of emotive.
Yeah,
well,
like
most of the movies, I like to silently play a game called what emotion is this person trying to convey?
That's a good idea.
Yeah, you can take any screenshot of any actor in this movie and go, what emotion are they trying to convey? And all of it is actor trying not to lose his job.
The point being, it locked us in to like the 35-minute mark. And from that point forward, you either veto it right there and you're like, all right, quit it. Or you're stuck. And we were stuck.
Well, at that point, we were only in the crime spree world, so I think all of us were like, well, we can at least got to see what the other worlds
are. Right, and they were bait and switching us.
Even,
like, he was in the crime spree world, then he'd leave for a bit, and then he'd come back, and then he'd leave for a bit.
I feel offended that you're trying to speak for me, sir.
I'm sorry.
Because I was...
I apologize.
I was not curious of what other worlds there would be, because I knew they would be ass. What I was thinking is, like, okay, so they did this. What happens for the rest of the movie? I did not give a flying fuck about zombie bodega or alien ranch or whatever the fuck. I don't care.
I'll be honest, I didn't either, but I did give a fuck in the sense of, like, watching it devolve further.
It didn't even devolve, though.
It did, though.
It just stayed as this blonde
like,
nothing burger.
Like, the city, maybe because the screen time was more, had way more shit in it. And then when they went to the zombie world, it was just, like...
Like Slender Man.
Like dead trees and rocks.
Like, you play, okay, you played Slenderman, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It reminds me of that, like, kind of, this is the tree texture.
But Slenderman at, like, 2 p.m. Like, yeah. In the middle of the day, not even, everything.
Don't even need a light.
Scary. Yeah.
Also, like, that the zombies were just, like, people in front of a green screen that they just, like, keyed out and just, like, put, they were, like, the Heartless or whatever from Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah. Yes. Right, which I would have been so happy if that's how it continued, was just, like, getting more and more ridiculous.
Like,
and
if the zombies were his friends copied and pasted.
Yeah, and he's just blasting people and making stomach plugs out of them, but, like, that just didn't happen.
Do you remember when they were in that cafe?
Yeah.
And it looked like screensaver people were, like, walking around in the background?
And see, that was tremendous, because that was in the crime and spree world. And then, like, they what?
I think you're right that
they backslash noclip into zombie bodega or whatever the fuck.
I think you're right that's
what hurt me. So he's exploring, walking around, getting his bearings, and it starts becoming Sin City, like this kind of like gritty, weird angles and a gravelly voice narrating, which is apparently him still.
The mean streets of Crime Spree were even meaner on the south side of town. Tough neighborhood, you better believe it.
So he goes to the crime lord and gets set on a mission to find the chick and bring her back to the crime lord?
Yeah, because she has a briefcase.
Who is the visage of the cop that killed his real-life girlfriend because he took a picture of the cop's face in a newspaper. Because
it asked, take a picture of someone you hate.
Yes.
And there's the cop that killed her.
Just very on the nose. Can you imagine how interesting that would be if the bad guy was his girlfriend? Like, something went wrong and they didn't bother
to
say.
We'll be here for another 4 hours.
There's nothing to fix.
Turns out the girl is his ex, or
but like Brown.
So of course he's like, "Oh my God, you're real! It's so nice to see you again." And she has no idea who he is.
And then he gets blasted in the shoulder by some dude who is one of his friends.
Yeah, and that's when he learns, like, "Oh, if you die in the video game, you die in real life," kind of thing. That trope. Is that the first time he asked the game to, like, make him leave?
Yeah, when he gets shot in the shoulder, that's what.
Because he's like, "Ow, this hurts! Help me, Mom! Help me!"
Yeah.
And then they're like,
"The game's like, fine, you big bitch."
So it takes him out, but then he starts seeing shit. The game's like attached to his brain or whatever the fuck.
Right.
So tries to go to work. His coworker is the kid from the Sandlot.
Right. Or arguably the baby head from Toy Story. Possibly the same person.
Wouldn't surprise me at all. So, anyway, he can't function in his life because the game keeps fucking with him. He tries to, like, go to the doctor at one point, and he's freaking out. So, anyway, he realizes he has to go back into the game. He has to beat it.
Puts the headset on for the second time. Comes back. Dies once in the diner.
In the cafe bar diner.
Bitches out again. The game's like, whatever.
And you think he stays there for the rest of the game, right?
He does. Like, that's the end of it. So, one thing that was never
addressed. No, he meets the fucking cop in the alleyway.
That's right.
Yeah.
On the way to his car, and he's like, "Yo, man, don't give me a ticket." And the cop's like, "Oh, shit, man.
I'll just give you fucking drugs
instead.
Fucked
up. You want some drugs, dog?" And he's like, "You killed my girlfriend." And he punches him in the face. And when he punches him in the face, then he falls asleep. And then he's in the game for the rest of the
night. Yeah, because he gets put into a coma, right? The cop hits him so hard.
Yeah. That or the game.
Or whatever.
Sends him to God, same day delivery. The on-paper goal of this video game is to defeat Woody Harrelson. Or was it to get the briefcase to some dickhead?
Yes.
Well, the overall arching thing of the game is if he defeats him in real life, hopefully he'll defeat his, I don't know, emotional state of trying to get over it, whatever.
You put way more thought in this than
I did. I'm trying to.
I've just been inarticulately screaming.
You have pretty much a lot of the movie.
Long story short, they leave crime world. They go to zombie world. It's less impressive. They fuck around there. One of his friends tries to convince him that he's a real boy. They leave there. They go to alien world. Friend convinces
You miss a 10-minute interlude in there where they're fake running around Slenderman's forest, and then black guy shows up and he's like, "Where are you going?" And they're like, "Blue Mountain." "Why are you going to Blue Mountain?" They're like, "We don't know." And then he's like, "It's an army base." And we're like, and then alien ranch.
They go through a hole in the ground. They come out of the hole in the ground and they're in alien world.
Which is orange. It's the only way I know.
He climbs a mountain. He dies. Climbs a mountain again. He shoots a man. Takes a heart. The bitch got her hand cut off.
And dies from it.
All he did was, he didn't, you know, when you cover a wound, you want to cover the actual bloody part. He just wrapped the handkerchief around her wrist.
Yeah.
And she bled out, which makes sense.
Immediately.
Yeah.
He did all of that to try and give her the heart. And the video game was like, it doesn't work that way. And then he's like, no, I wanted to. And he's like, all right. So he does. And then he learns to sacrifice. He
gives her an extra life or something.
Yeah.
The game says a lot of things that it immediately gives up on. The game has no self-confidence. Yeah, he's like, I want out of the game. And the game's like, no one can leave the game. You're stuck in the game.
He literally.
And he's like, exit, cancel, delete.
Control, alt, delete. Alt, F4.
He literally sits on the ground and pouts.
Literally, right. This is like no exaggeration.
Child. And the game is like, fine!
Well, he's pouting on the ground and some wiggly thing alien. Is like, I'm gonna blast you in the goddamn face. Right. And he's like, no! And then his little
magical bracelet. Like,
his Thanos power gauntlet thingy is just like, I got you, Holmes.
But the game reneges on all these things literally it says everything. That are unmovable.
It's like a first-time parent, just like
she's
no.
dead. You can't bring her back with a heart. And he's I want her back. And she's in the game's like, okay, well, you can use sure one of your would. Lives, whatever. Who cares?
And then after that, they are chased by main bad guy, which is
William Harrelson.
Yeah, William Harrelson.
Well, because he does see this stupid tattoo on this her shitty stripper tattoo.
It's really bad. I'm assuming it looks like a ski pass.
Right.
Like she went to like.
And lo and behold. It's a blue mountain.
Get it?
So you know when you're drunk and you're a woman and you got tits, you're feeling yourself?
Yeah.
And you're like, I'm going to get a tattoo. I don't care what it is. And you go to the tattoo parlor and instead of a heart or a unicorn or a butterfly or some shit, you're like, I want a fucking mountain on my ass. And you get a mountain right above your asshole. That's what she did. They go to the real world for some reason. They look at his corpse on a bed.
And Sam was about to have a brain aneurysm, thinking that he was going to penetrate his own body and just like
take control of it.
I was convinced that the game world and in the real life were going to merge.
Yeah.
And like a digital version of her was just going to be hanging out with his real life friends and they're going to beat the boss together.
That would have been fun.
And then the movie Her happens and this is really the prequel to it.
Right.
Yeah, it's a beautiful movie.
They leave the real-life hospital to go into the boiler room of the hospital that is suddenly a green-screen nightmare
cartoon
world.
Boiler
like,
room.
Just yeah. literally a stage yeah. in Silent Hill, but, like, if I described it to someone over the phone.
Final fight scene, main characters are fighting a cop ninja boss.
Samurai Baldman.
Yeah.
Follows them down.
Literally samurai cop.
I look forward to that dollar bin of doom.
Price. I wish I could find it for a dollar. The last 50 minutes of the movie have been them shooting at Samurai Cop, and he's deflecting bullets.
Right.
49 minutes later, they think, hey, let's try something different. So to defeat the bad guy, he leaves one of his lives out in the world and turns off the lights.
Yeah, and then Samurai Cop is like, ooh, a piece of candy. Exactly. And then he's like, I'm going to eat it.
That's literally the point I was going to bring up, is that's what attracts him to it. It's his beacon of like, ooh, a free life in the video game world.
He doesn't need the life. He was just walking around.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Like, he wasn't even going for it. It just the light from the red thing silhouetted him so that the good guys could
just
shoot him.
Like a moth.
He was just curious about it. He's a moth.
No. He was just trolling, man. It was just in his path. He didn't think anything of it. He was looking for them, happened to walk by it, and they were laying on the ground.
For a long
shot
time.
Shot him through the fucking chest.
End of the fight scene. But no, it's the most anticlimactic.
We were relieved. We knew it was almost over.
Yeah.
So anyway.
End of the movie, she's like, oh, you got to go back to your world. I'm not real.
He shakes her and he says, I saw your blue mountain on your butt. You're the blue mountain. Open the case. And she opens the case.
And it's the fucking.
And he's like, I'm not leaving you because I'm stupid. And she's like, I know you are, but go. And they push the button.
They kiss and it hurts his face.
Yeah.
He literally looks like he's about to die.
She pushes individual sour Skittles into his mouth, and his face just retracts into itself.
He ejaculates white light from his crotch.
Yeah.
He wakes up in a coma. Nurse is there, and she's like, oh, my God, you're awake. And then the cop bursts in and is like, if you fucking tell anyone what's going on.
The same cop who beat him up and tried to sell him drugs.
Real-life version of Samurai Cop.
Which makes a lot of sense. If you're a shady character who wants to keep somebody quiet, you would, and you had the ability to be outside of their hospital room, you would.
And then it just kind of ends.
Yeah, we get a little bit of the, like, he grows as a person, he changes his hairstyle.
He does?
Yeah.
Yeah, he no longer looks like a fucking
a
dumpster
fat,
fire.
Grumpy douche. He looks in real life the way he did in the video game, which was
hey,
like super cool.
Aaron,
dude.
His fucking character developed. The movie was telling you his character developed, and you're supposed to know his character developed.
He became fit.
Look,
Kurt.
He coiffs his hair now, motherfucker. He's developed.
Yeah. He goes to the barbecue where everyone has been drinking for 9 hours, apparently.
Since last time they asked him week ago.
Yeah, seriously.
Like, we were just waiting for you, and we didn't want to go home, and these hot dogs are really good. I didn't want to put them away.
Did you bring any beer?
We're almost out.
What,
were you in a coma? And he's like, yes,
I watched the West, thank you.
And how does the movie end? Samurai cop getting the Roomba, and he puts it on his head.
Oh, yeah, weirdly.
And then Robert Zombie starts playing. Bob Zombie.
Doug Zombie.
Doug Zombert.
Doug Zamboni.
Yeah, I like that.
Fucking stop. I don't like That's this good. Anymore.
Kevin, what would you give whatever the fuck this
is called? I wanted to go last.
Okay.
I would give it one full dollar. No, of course. I'm giving it 0 cents. This was not even fun to watch.
Wow. Okay.
I'm going to renege. 25 cents because the first quarter of the movie was silly and enjoyable.
Okay, so 25 cents?
25 cents.
That's amazing considering how much you hated it.
Yeah, again, like I said, it gets any amount of currency for the first quarter of the movie because it was so funny because he was such a bad actor and because when you first get introduced to Grand Theft Auto Sin City, you're just like, this is amazing. Yeah. I love this. I hope it gets better from here. And then do not pass go. Do not collect $200. Do not touch the coin return button. You are stuck here. Go fuck yourself.
Yeah. I would give it 40 cents.
Any reason why?
It hurt.
It really did.
But it was interesting. And it sparked a good conversation. So it had substance. Which is not something that you can say about all these movies.
Did it have substance?
It did.
Does white bread count as substance? I guess
it
does.
It did when it's moldy and wet. And I want to meet the man who looked at that on the editing bay and was like, I did a good job. I want to meet him and I want to hug him and I want to tell him I'm sorry that you're homeless.
And then shoot him in the fucking face and call it a life.
And no, I would press his eyes into his skull
and
slowly
just rip it open.
And he wouldn't even cry.
Can I leave before he gives his response?
Yeah, you're not gonna like me in about 3 seconds.
Yeah,
Kevin,
go before I hurt you.
I know this is a movie I'm gonna remember for a long time. I'm gonna enjoy it the more I think about it.
You're never gonna watch it again, though.
I would watch it again. There's not a lot of movies. I want to rewatch this at some point, not tomorrow. I think typically I would maybe give this like 80 cents.
Uh-huh.
But I know future me is going to be angry about not giving it a dollar. So I'm going to give it a dollar.
If you stay quiet for like 30 seconds, you can hear my soul leave my body.
Yeah, your teeth were longer when you came in today. Yeah. You've been grinding them down very slowly while watching this. Now, I just, it's baffling and weird, and I loved. I want to rewatch it and catch all the things I missed.
Yeah.
I think right now is when I'm going to put up an image of our conversation of when I ask you how you felt about this, sleeping on it for like a week, because I'll see if it changes.
Yeah.
Because again, a lot of the movies we watched later, I'm like, I like that more. Or like, fuck, I actually liked that.
You might have to reach out and talk to someone else. They'll probably be in a medically induced coma at that
point.
True.
You'll be playing the game box. Yeah. The meta-ness of this movie is what I'm really curious about. Was it the, we're trying our best, and this is the best we can do? Or is it, like, cynical, good enough, people will fucking buy it? Or
was
it
the G4 exec that's like, we need a movie for the...
We need a video
We need
game
a movie.
Movie
for this time slot.
Yeah. Well, Aaron...
Fuck you.
Okay. Well, that answers
Thanks
my question.
Thanks for coming, man. It's always fun to have you here. Yeah. Glad you came. Glad you the natty daddy's back.
The natty daddy
has come to reclaim his throne.
Yeah. Oh god. I don't like this. Watch, one day I'm gonna try to buy a Tesla and he's like, I heard what you said on fucking Miserable People.
I know.
They're my favorite channel on YouTube. I fucking love them, dude.
Why don't you go fuck yourself, Buckaroo?
Elon, if you're fucking listening, shout a brother out.
Yeah, man, come on. Yeah. So, some Tesla. We put a car into space. Also, cue up the video, guys. And then
yeah. You're like one tweet away from making our lives infinitely better. So chop chop there,
like,
Elon.
Like what? 80 of your 132 viewers is Elon naked in his basement. Just like, I fucking love these guys. I keep waiting for like the exit tune to leave. And I'm like, no, wait. And it doesn't just come out of the walls.
No, I have to do that. I'll do it better on the day.
I'm depressed.
I do it better. I don't have my guitar with me, so.